and it won't stop. Oh, oh.
Hey, little angels. Okay, so today I'm going to be telling you guys a story time. So in my last mukbang, like Q&A / Buffalo Wild Wings mukbang, I answered a question that had to do with why I don't really drive, why I never ended up driving. And I ended up telling you guys that I got into a car accident and you guys wanted a story time on that. So that's what I'm going to be doing today. I hope that you guys enjoy this story time. If you do, give it a like and hit the subscribe button if you want to. So yeah, pretty much the way that this story time starts off, like the setting, is I was 15 years old. I was literally, I believe, about 2 weeks, like around 2 weeks away from getting my permit. I had just taken driver's ed, everything. I had just gotten my hours in, everything. Like, I really was about to get my permit, I believe, and then my license. So I used to go to this modeling school. I don't really know what the actual name for it is, but they pretty much like just taught you how to be a model or an actress, whatever you wanted to be. And that was in Cary, North Carolina. I live in Rocky Mount, North Carolina. So pretty much that was always like a 2.5 hour drive every Saturday to and from. So it was pretty annoying. I honestly hated it, but because the drive was so long, like it was literally 2.5 hours every single day, me and my mom would usually spend like the whole day in Cary or Raleigh, wherever we went. So we just so happened to go to Knightdale, North Carolina, which is like kind of around that same area, I guess, like where Cary and Raleigh are. And we went to this store called Kohl's. A lot of you probably know that. That's my mom's favorite store. I actually like it a lot too. So we went in there, we did our shopping or whatever, we got a few things, and we left. And if you guys have ever been, which obviously not a lot of you watching this video probably will have, but as soon as you come out of like the shopping center where Kohl's is and you turn right, there's like a huge intersection. So pretty much in the car, in the front seat was my mom, and in the back seat was me and my friend because I wanted to sit beside them. So we pretty much just got settled in the car, and then we ended up driving and leaving the Kohl's like shopping center because it was like a Target and stuff like that. So we ended up turning right and heading up to that intersection, and we stopped because we were just sitting at a red light. So while we were at that red light, I remember it was such a long red light, like it was taking forever because it was kind of a big intersection. Like, it wasn't the biggest one, but like it was a pretty big one. So this is when it starts to happen. Like, this is when we're really getting into the part where things go wrong. So I was just chilling in the back seat. I had my seatbelt on. I was always like on my shit about that. I always have been, I always will be. And my friend across from me actually did not have their seatbelt on, and my mom had her seatbelt on. So our light turns green, right? So we let off the brake and we start going, and my mom's driving, by the way. I don't know if I said that, but my mom's driving and we start going. And you know how like when you first start driving, you're obviously going slow because you were at a complete stop. But like the intersection was so big that we drove enough to get enough like speed in. But pretty much what ended up happening was we were in like the lane closest to the left, but where you still go straight, like not the turning left lane, just the lane closest to the left. So on the other side of the intersection, like our opposite side that we're facing, to the left of us, because it was her right, this lady's over here trying to U-turn into our lane. So obviously she can do that, that's not illegal, but you have to go when the light is green. Her light was red because ours was green. So we just start going straight, we're literally just getting some speed to us, and I'm talking to my friend that's over here to my left. I have no idea what we're talking about, to be honest, but we're just talking, and I end up turning to my right to look over through the windshield, and I literally see this car turning in front of us, and we're heading right at them. Like, we weren't going extremely fast, obviously, but we were going pretty fast. And so I end up yelling like, "Mom," you know, because I had to let her know just in case she didn't. I'm pretty sure she did at that point though. But she started hitting her brakes, but not too hard. Like, nobody got hurt or anything. Nobody had whiplash or anything. And we still end up hitting this car on their side. The lady in the other car was really shaken up, and I understand why, because she was just making a left turn. You know, she probably didn't mean to run that red light, obviously. So she was just probably going about her day, making a left turn, and then she just gets hit out of nowhere. Like, that would scare the living crap out of me. So we end up hitting the side of this car with the front of our car, and I remember we like backed up and we like drove off the road because we were in the middle of an intersection, and so we didn't want like anybody to hit us or to block any traffic or anything like that. And it turns out that was actually smart of us, apparently. Apparently they would have like fined us if we didn't do that, and there would have been a fee for it. And during the accident, I remember like after I saw the car coming, because I was the first one to see it, I like had my seatbelt right here, right? And I like clenched up like as much as I could and grabbed onto my seatbelt. And when the cars hit, I like flew, you know? Like, I didn't actually fly out because my seatbelt was right there, but I like went forward a little bit. And I will never forget, that sound was so loud. It's almost like, I did forget it. It's almost like I can't remember how loud it was because it was like so loud. So when I finally like realized what happened, I was like, oh my God, I started freaking out. I started having a little panic attack because at that point in my life, I had just started having panic attacks and my anxiety was like really, really bad. So when I started realizing what was happening, I started like looking around and I looked to my left and I see the other lady's car and her car looked just smacked. That car was really, really messed up. Like her car, she probably had to buy a new car, to be honest. That car was honestly way more messed up than you would think it would be. But our car was a silver Tahoe. And in the thumbnail and right here, I'm going to put a picture of this other person's car that I found online that looks just like our car after the wreck. Like exactly like it. That's why I put it in the thumbnail and in this video, because our whole front, like, what is that thing called? Our whole front hood was like completely bent up. Like you could only see a little bit past it when you look through the windshield. And the airbag, my mom's airbag actually went off, but it didn't hit her. Like she didn't hit the steering wheel or anything. All of us, by the way, like nobody was really hurt, but all of us in the car had like a freaking seatbelt, like bruise on our chest because it had like yanked us kind of hard, you know, when we stopped. I ended up like, you know, asking everybody like, are you okay? Are you okay? Everybody was fine. We had to get out, but my door couldn't open and the door in front of me couldn't open. So I had to get out on my friend's door, like the friend to my left. I believe my mom had to too because her door wouldn't open either. So when we had finally gotten out of the car and stuff, we were standing on the grass near the intersection and I looked to my left and I saw the other lady, you know, and I never said anything to her, which is crazy because I was younger. So I guess I didn't realize like that's kind of rude. Like that's extremely rude. But honestly, these days I would have gone up to her, but for some reason I didn't. Everybody was rushing us, like the paramedics were rushing us. She was laying on the ground, like the other lady that got hit, she was so shaken up that she was laying on the ground. I think something ended up happening to her neck. Like she needed one of those like neck braces or something because she ended up later like trying to sue us, I think, which I mean, I don't know why she would do that, to be honest. We were like really nice about it and we were just like, you know what, let's just go on our way. Our insurance will take care of it, I guess. Like we didn't do anything to her. We weren't rude to her. And it was like her fault and she was trying to sue us because maybe she couldn't afford like the healthcare that was required for her neck brace, but obviously she didn't win. Like she didn't get to sue us or anything, so. But yeah, that was the first car accident that I was in. I was actually in a second one. This was when I was going to my junior prom. It was like literally 2 days before my junior prom, I believe. Two or three. And my mom had a migraine. She suffers from chronic migraines, so she has migraines a ton, like all the time. And she knew that it was the last day she could pick up our prom dresses from the place that we got them hemmed at. By the way, guys, I mean me and my best friend at the time. And so for this whole week, we had plans that she would take me and my best friend to the dress place so that we could pick up our dresses, try them on, see how they look, and then take us home. So pretty much we got the dresses, we tried them on, everything was okay. And when we got back in the car, we were actually in downtown Rocky Mount, North Carolina. So if you have ever been to Rocky Mount, you know downtown Rocky Mount, like the roads are a little bit different. They're kind of older, so they have a lot of one-ways. They're pretty confusing for me, maybe not for other people, but for me they are. And so I guess maybe having a migraine, my mom kind of got a little bit mixed up. And like, you know, like if you have a migraine, that can really alter what's going on. That can really, really affect you and make you not focus on the right things. So pretty much she ended up running a red light in just a normal, like small intersection, to be honest. But the people that were like having the green light were the people coming this way. So when we ran the red light, this guy hit the very like the left back tire of our Tahoe. He hit that with the front of his car, but it was our fault though. And we started swerving after that. We were swerving so much. I will never forget that. That was so scary. And I had my puppy in my arms. I was holding him so like tight. So she ended up straightening up, my mom did, and she stopped the car. Turns out the guy who hit us was a freaking like a firefighter. And we wrecked right outside of a police department. So all the policemen were coming over to this one firefighter guy, like being like, oh, are you okay? Are you okay? So when the lady came up to us to like give us our ticket, because obviously it was our fault, she like wrote it and she was like, yeah, you know you hit one of our like head firefighters, right? I was like, what is going on? I understand this was my mom's fault, but like there's no need to make her feel bad about it. Like she was crying, like she felt so bad about it, and this lady was such a bitch to her. Me and my best friend both looked at each other like, who the hell does she think she is? But in both of those wrecks, guys, nobody ended up getting any serious injuries at all. But unfortunately, it did really, really scare the crap out of me when it happened. The first wreck did. I ended up never getting my permit. I still don't have my license. I can drive, like I can get in a car and I can drive down the street. But I just, when another car starts approaching me, I freak out. I freeze up and I'm just afraid to go into intersections. Intersections are like the most terrifying thing ever to me. And to be honest, and my mom knows this, because she was the driver in both the wrecks, for some reason I'm just very, very weird when she drives. I'm very like on edge and anxious and cautious about everything. But yeah guys, that was my story time on the first time I got into a car accident, and the second time too, even though I'm just titling it about the first one. For those of you who wanted to know it, I hope that, I don't know, maybe you could relate or you enjoyed it. So if you did, please give it a like and hit the subscribe button if you want to. Thank you guys so much for watching my videos. I love you guys so much, and I'll see y'all in my next one. Bye guys. We can just dance to this. Don't take much to stop me. We can just dance to this. Push up on my body.